In today's video, I'm showing you how you can make the new 5x1 vertical trend in Premiere Pro. First, create a new sequence by going to File and then hitting New Sequence. Hit Ari and choose 1080p at 23.976. You'll need to make this a 1080p sequence versus a 4K one because the highest resolution accepted on Instagram Reels and TikTok is currently 1080p. Maybe in the future they'll accept 4K, but as of right now, it's only 1080p. Lastly, at the bottom, name your sequence Master 5x1 Vertical. So once you get that out of the way, convert this sequence into a vertical one. You can do this by going to Sequences at the top, then Sequence Settings, and change the frame size to 1080 by 1920. For step two, you're gonna wanna make 5 more sequences with your different video clips. The reason for doing this is because to resize and position your clips to look correct in your timeline, you're gonna need to set boundaries for these videos. To start, right-click on your master sequence and hit duplicate. Double-click on the new sequence, go to sequence, sequence settings, and beside 1920, type /5 and enter. This will automatically divide 1920 by 5, giving you the exact vertical value you need to fit 5 video clips into your sequence. Click OK and rename this sequence as Video 1. Now duplicate this sequence 5 times. To do this, right-click on the sequence and hit Duplicate. From here, import the clips you would like to use into each of the video sequences and make sure all your clips are the same length. As a safe bet, I'm making all my clips 15 seconds long, giving you the flexibility to change the timing for any of them. Now click on your master sequence and drag and drop all your video sequences into the master sequence timeline. Before you do this, ensure you have the blue icon enabled to ensure you have no complications with framing and crop points. Now stack all your clips on top of one another and remove the audio channels. From here, move each video sequence to its correct spot to fill the remainder of the frame. To make this easier, go to the workspaces icon in the top right and change the layout to vertical. This will give you a better view to line up all your clips correctly. I found going from the bottom to the top is the fastest way to get all your clips aligned. You can do this by using the position parameter in the effects window. Step three is exporting for the highest quality as possible. To do this, hold Command M on your keyboard while in the master sequence, change the preset to Match Source Adaptive High Bitrate, and then open up the video tab and check render at maximum depth and render quality, and change the bitrate to 30. The bitrate will have a direct correlation to the file size. Hit export and you're done, my friend. If you're looking to learn more about stylizing your footage and make it stand out, check out this video right here and how I color graded and set up my drone to produce the highest quality as possible. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you have any questions, make sure to let me know in the comment section down below and send me a DM on Instagram if you have any other questions relating to filmmaking. That's it for me, guys. I will see you in the next one.